Hi, I'm Elizabeth.
Hi everyone, I'm Lucy.
Hi, I'm Allison.
This is Banjo Betsy Beckerman.
And welcome to Baby Time, a fun, interactive program for parents and caregivers of babies ages 0 to 2, full of ideas for songs, rhymes, baby bounces, stories, activities, and more to do with your baby.
Hello, 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 and how are you? We're fine, we're fine. Hope that you are too. Hello, 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 and how are you? We're fine, we're fine. Hope that you are too. Welcome to our house for stories, books, and songs. We're glad that you're we hope you sing along. Hello, 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 and how are you? We're fine, we're fine. Hope that you are too. Hello, 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 and how are you? We're fine, we're fine. We hope that you are too.
Kids of all ages love balloons. But so often we get balloons when we're out and about, if we see someone selling them on the street, or if we're at a fair or a circus, something like that. But balloons are especially fun inside the house because they can't float away. And they can be used for babies all the way up to bigger kids. For your baby who's not yet walking, who maybe is doing a lot of laying on their back and playing with something that's hanging above them, it can be really fun to very loosely tie 2 helium balloons to their ankles. Baby will kick and the balloons will bounce and move above them. They'll be able to see that they can control the balloon's movement based on how they move their legs and feet. So they're getting a sense of their own body while amusing themselves with the balloons. For slightly older kids, you can just get an inexpensive pack of balloons at the store and blow them up yourself. Kids love when there's 10 or 20 balloons filling a room that they can kick and bat and play around with. You really don't even need the helium for those. It can be such a treat for a toddler to see balloons in their house when they usually think of them for a special occasion. If they see a room filled with them, it brings them so much joy and delight and hours of entertainment. So try some balloon fun with your baby and your toddler.
Hi, I want to show you a fun little song today that you can do when you're getting baby up in the morning or from a nap, holding them like this if you've just woken them up. It's also a really good song to do on their back, on the changing table maybe, or anywhere that you're changing baby. If you have an older baby, they can stand up and do the motions themselves, which is also always fun. So this is called Wake Up Feet. Wake up feet, wake up feet, wake up feet and wiggle, wiggle, wiggle. Wake up feet, wake up feet, wake up and wiggle in the morning. Wake up hands, wake up hands, wake up hands and wiggle, wiggle, wiggle. Wake up hands, wake up hands, wake up and wiggle in the morning. And you can do any part that you want. You could do ears, wake up ears, wake up ears, wake up ears and wiggle, wiggle, wiggle. Wake up ears, wake up ears, wake up and wiggle in the morning. And one thing that's really fun to do if you have an older baby who's standing up on their own is to wake up their whole body, because it's always fun to wiggle your whole body. So you could just go, wake up body, wake up body, wake up body and wiggle, wiggle, wiggle. Wake up body, wake up body, wake up and wiggle in the morning. So I hope you give this song a try. As you can see, it has endless possibilities and it's a fun way to just get baby going or to wake baby up from a nap or to con them on a changing table or just to have fun with an older baby. So give it a try.
Hi, everybody. I have another little activity for us to try out with Baby, and this is seeking out the squeak. So what we are going to do is hide a squeaky toy or a ball or maybe a rattle or shaker, some sort of toy that makes a noise. We are going to hide it underneath a small blanket or a small towel. Then we can shake whatever toy is underneath the towel or blanket so that it makes that noise. And give baby some time to listen to that muffled noise coming from underneath the towel or blanket and see if baby can figure out where that noise is coming from. It might take them quite a while. Hopefully they will turn their head to see where exactly the sound is coming from, but you can always help baby figure out where the toy is hidden. And once they discover the toy, you can praise them for it. So this can be a pretty fun activity, sort of like a baby scavenger hunt, if you will. Try it out, see how it goes, and hope to see you soon. Bye-bye.
Well, Frosty the snowman was a jolly, happy soul, with a corncob pipe and a button nose and two eyes made out of coal. Frosty the snowman is a fairy tale, they say. He was made of snow, but the children know how he came to life one day. There must have been some magic in that old silk hat they found, for when they placed it on his head, he began to dance around. Was alive as he could be, and the children say he can laugh and play just the same as you and me. Frosty the snowman knew the sun was hot that day, so he said, let's run and we'll have some fun now before I melt away. Down to the village with a broomstick in his hand, running here and there all around the square, saying, catch me if you can. He led them down the streets of town, right to the traffic cop, and he only paused a moment when he heard him holler, stop! For Frosty the snowman had to hurry on his way, but he said goodbye, saying, don't you cry, I'll be back again someday. Thumpity thump thump, thumpity thump thump, look at Frosty go. Thumpity thump thump, thumpity thump thump, over the hills of snow.
One thing that we often don't think about doing with babies and young toddlers is looking at photos. That seems to be kind of an activity for adults, looking back at memories. But babies love to look at photos of people that they recognize. And it can be really helpful, especially in times like these, to show your baby photos of people that they might not be able to see as regularly as you would like. It's especially great if you can have printed photos to lay out that baby can touch and actually feel in their hands, or if you have a photo book that you can open up for them. But you can show them pictures of grandma and grandpa. You can show them pictures of friends and neighbors. You can show them pictures of people who are in the house, their older sibling or their younger sibling if they have one. You can show them pictures of yourself and have them recognize that you're there with them, but the picture of you is in front of them. And show them pictures of themselves too, maybe making different faces, or when they were younger, they'll recognize that they're beginning to grow up and change. This is also great for showing baby pictures if mom is maybe at work and they're a little sad. You can show them a picture of mom. They might start to feel better, or dad, or whoever. This is a really cool way for babies to start to recognize the people that are in their lives who care about them and to see what those people look like at different times in their own lives. Try getting some pictures out for your baby to see what they think of this activity.
Hi, I have a little song to share with you today. It's a short, sweet little song, but it's a nice song for trying to get baby calmed down into bed at night or during nap time. It's called Way Up in the Sky. You start with your two little birds. Way up in the sky, the little birds fly. When down in the nest, the little birds rest. With the wing on the left and a wing on the right, those sweet little birdies sleep all through the night. Hi, I have a little song to show you today. It's very short and sweet, but it's a great song for getting baby tucked into bed at night or down for a nap. It's called Way Up in the Sky. It goes like this. Way up in the sky, the little birds fly. When down in the nest, the little birds rest. With a wing on the left and a wing on the right, those sweet little birdies, they sleep through the night. Let's try that one more time. Way up in the sky, the little birds fly. When down in the nest, the little birds rest. With a wing on the left and a wing on the right, those sweet little birdies, they sleep through the night.
Hi, everybody. Allison here, back with another activity that we can do while we are spending more time indoors during the winter with baby. And this activity is making a seesaw for a teddy bear or other stuffed animal. So you will need a sturdy cardboard tube or something similar, and a large, thin hardcover book or something similar. All you need to do is lay the sturdy cardboard tube down on the ground and then place the book on top of it, and it will make a little seesaw. This is especially good if your baby loves dropping things or throwing toys. All you need to do is, once you have the seesaw set up, place a stuffed animal or teddy bear on one side of the book and then press down sharply on the other side. Teddy bear will lift into the air and fly through the air. And then you and baby can go get the teddy bear or stuffed animal together. This is fun for a couple reasons. One, baby will love watching their toy fly through the air. At the same time, while that toy is flying through the air, baby is tracking that with their eyes, watching it move across the room with their eyes. And they're also practicing picking up that toy. So try it out. See how it goes, and we'll see you soon. Bye-bye.
Thou horses, what's the time of day? Thou horses, what's the time of day? 1 o'clock, 2 o'clock,
try it again.
I shake my bells up high. One more time.
I shake my bells up high. I shake my bells down low. I shake it, shake it, shake it, shake it.
Thanks so much for joining us for Baby Time. Be sure to stay tuned to our AADL.TV YouTube channel for more great programming. See you soon.